Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about the Automobile Expo that's going to happen in Delhi in the month of February. Now, there's a lot to say about this in the sense that a lot of automobile manufacturers are not participating in this event, and there are a lot of reasons for that. We're going to be discussing all that in this video, and there are a lot of manufacturers are going to be also attending the video, and we're going to be just quickly checking out and showing you all which cars are going to be attending the show. And I'm just going to put small photos up of them, so we'll discuss all that in this video. So guys, the reason why a lot of automobile manufacturers are not attending the show is for multiple reasons, like I said earlier, and I'm just going to list them down. So right now, the cost of the show is extremely high, and the automobile industry in India is at a slowdown, where the amount of cars that are getting sold have reduced, and automobile manufacturers are primarily focusing on the requirements of the Bharat Stage 6 engines that are required to come out now. So the attention is focused out there, and a lot of automobile manufacturers are not coming as a result of this. There are a few which are making their presence felt out there, but there are also some new automobile manufacturers who are debuting for the first time in India with their vehicles. So that's also pretty cool, but overall it's very sad that a lot of automobile manufacturers have decided to step out and not attend the 15th edition of this Auto Expo, which is going to happen in Delhi in Noida. So guys, amongst the car manufacturers who are not going to be attending the show are Honda, BMW, Toyota, Ford, FCA, which is Jeep and Fiat, Audi, Lexus, Volvo, Jaguar, Range Rover is also not going to be attending the event, and Citroen. Citroen is going to be launching its first car in India, but they have decided not to participate in the event. So they were going to debut their car, first car in India, and they have decided to not participate in the event. Don't know the exact reason why they have not participating, but like I said, a lot of manufacturers are finding the cost very high. As a result, they are stepping out of this entire event, and they're focusing their attention on other pressing issues like the Bharat Stage 6 engines that have to come out immediately now. So guys, the only luxury manufacturer that is going to be attending the event is Mercedes-Benz. No other luxury manufacturer is attending the event, like Jaguar, Range Rover are out, Audi, BMW are also not participating. So the only one is Mercedes-Benz. So now let's talk about the manufacturers who are going to be attending. So we have Maruti Suzuki is going to be attending, Hyundai who's going to be attending and also debuting its Creta facelift. We'll come to that a little bit later. Tata Motor is also going to be debuting, and they're very excited to launch their Nexon EV. We have Mahindra, and Mahindra is going to be attending with a large range of SUVs. We have Kia Motor, who's also going to be attending, and obviously other than the Seltos, they'll also be launching a few new cars that they're going to be debuting in the show as well. We have MG Motor, who's also excited about its EV. Renault is going to be participating. Volkswagen, Skoda is also going to be participating. And finally, like I said earlier, Mercedes-Benz is going to be participating, being the only luxury manufacturer out there. So Tata Motors is expected to attend the event with, say, approximately 10 cars, amongst which the Altroz is supposed to be one of them. It's a very celebrated car, and it's already out. We know that this car is already out, but they're going to be debuting it with their 1.2-litre petrol and a 1.5-litre diesel engine. And they also have the Altroz EV, which we hope to see out there. The Nexon EV, like I said earlier, is also going to be out there. And the Nexon facelift, the regular facelift, they also have the H2X concept that's also going to be out there as well. Hyundai is going to be attending the event also with 5 new cars possibly, or even more. We know for a fact that the new Creta is going to be there. The entire facelift and the revamp of the Creta is going to be there, as well as a lot of other facelifts are going to be there, which include the i20, the Elantra, and a lot of other cars. The Tuscan is also going to be out there. So a lot of exciting things to see from Hyundai's end. MG is also going to be making some special debuts. One car that we know for a fact that is going to be there is the EZS. So that is also something exciting to look at, because that goes in competition with Hyundai and the Tata Nexon, the EVs of them. Although Tata Nexon is quite a lot cheaper as compared to the MG Motors EV. Kia is also going to be attending the event with a few new cars, like we mentioned earlier. Obviously, the Seltos is going to be one of the cars which are going to be there, along with the QYI and another car as well. The Skoda Auto Volkswagen is also going to be attending with approximately 8 cars. Skoda has a lot of cars to show when it comes to its facelift. That includes some new cars as well as the facelift of the original cars that exist, like the Superb and the Kodiaq. We also have some other cars that are going to be coming from Skoda as well. Maruti Suzuki is also going to be showing some facelift of its original cars, and also will possibly be displaying its EV car that will try to come in competition with the Nexon, but we are going to be looking forward to something like that from Maruti Suzuki as well. Renault will also be appearing at the show with its HBC car, which will give direct competition to Suzuki's Desire. So that will be something to look forward as well, because the Suzuki Desire, for your guys' information, is the best selling car in India at the moment. So maybe the HBS might change figures in that, but we never know. It might not be the case as well. Mercedes-Benz is also going to be appearing. Like I said earlier, it's going to be the only luxury manufacturer to come out there. But the most exciting thing about the luxury brand that Mercedes is going to be attending is that they are going to be showing the all-electric SUV, the EQS, is what everyone is looking forward to look at. It was, I think, displayed at the Dubai Motor Show also last year, and they're going to be showcasing it out here. That is an all-electric SUV coming from Mercedes-Benz, and it is pure luxury and pure electric. Now coming to the segment where we talk about the new cars that are going to get debuted, the new manufacturers who are debuting themselves and their cars in the country, and out of which we have the Great Wall, which is from Great Wall, which is from China, obviously, and they have their SUV segment cars, which is the Humvee, which is going to be showcasing some of its SUVs as well. The H4, the H6 and the H9, I believe, might be appearing, but I'm not 100% sure, but I'm going to be putting up photos of them so that you can get a better idea. First Automobile Works, another Chinese company that's going to be debuting itself in India, and they also be going to display some of the SUV cars which they have from their segments in the automobile show that's going to happen in Delhi in February 2020. So guys, that wraps up this video. I hope you'll enjoy this video. If you all did, please do like, subscribe, share button, and I'm not sure if I'm going to be attending the event. I really was looking forward to, but when I realized that a lot of automobile manufacturers have backed out and are not sure if they're going to be attending the event, I was not sure if I'm going to attend. And like I stay in Mumbai and have to go all the way to Delhi to make the show, I really wanted to create content for the channel and for you all guys to see what cars are there. But unfortunately, I might just skip out of this thing. I will keep you all posted as to what I plan on doing, if I plan on going or not. But like I said, this entire thing is a slight disappointment because a lot of people have decided to back out as a result of the multiple reasons that we spoke about earlier. So guys, if you all did like this video, please hit the like, subscribe, share button, and you can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. The name is the same, The Motoring Gossip, and I hope to see you on the next one. Cheers.